play ever. It just doesn't make sense.
Beware.
What are these mage minions doing?
I smell black magics.
You do realize you're on my side.
It's a fucking Dan of having Sombra. I took that on purpose, so that maybe he would go in me with Diana, but they didn't go. Because Tekken was behind me, that's why I did that shit. Oh, I'm dead. Okay, how far is her flash? Does she flash over this wall? I think she lets me go.
I hear the innocent cry.
I'm so sad. I'm so fucking sad. I'm so sad.
In the dark, all is laid.
I had to live through that last E-proc so that I can flash away from his Q when he goes into passive, but I didn't live, so maybe I should just flash immediately. So sad.
I release them from their pain. The enemy has been slain. Cleansing blood with silver. They will be purified.
I'm gonna learn you about me!
I pass judgment.
Ah! Bruh, man. Like, rolling up with Diana and Kled at the same time. They even have Zed coming top lane. If in case I try to run down the Diana, I promise you I would've killed that Diana. If the Zed wasn't there, I would've kept running her down, dodged her next Q, and then fucking just killed. But then the Zed's like chilling around the corner, just throw a quick W, throw a quick ult, and dead. I'm like, well, so I can't go there. Also, whenever I go cut down against Kled, later stages of the game, I feel so pressured to not go an HP item. So he's like, you don't want to lose value out of your cut down, but then you want HP so you don't die. So you're like, what the fuck do I build? Gargoyle Stoneplate, guys. That is the song. That's the song. Blood with silver. They sent Kled bot lane. What is going on here? What's going on here, eh, bud? What's going on here, eh, bud? Why isn't the Kled showing up top end anymore? He didn't want to skate around the rink, he went bot lane. Got a cold one with Caitlyn. Divine Sunder Vayne. Hell no. Tips against Kled? Spacing will be key so that you never get hit by his E. Don't get hit by his E. Getting hit by his Q is okay sometimes, but obviously dodge that too, and then you should be fine. So whenever you watch my spacing, I will space in a way where I'll never get hit by his E. If I do get hit by his E, that means I fucked up. His ass is bot lane. No shit, you're gonna die, brother. They sent Karthus into me, man. That's how. They're like, I don't wanna go top against this Vayne anymore. He'd rather go bot lane and then send his support Karthus top lane. That's so odd. That's good, man. This guy needs some milk. Oh yeah. That's too fucking good. I thought that Karthus had exhaust though, because I had to clear the exhaust and I tanked like 2 tower shots to clear it. This Annie knows how to play the game, you can tell. when she clicked S there, right when Kled would likely press EQ, she held S. No one is watching top lane. Top lane is just free. It's all for me. I get first blood tower here, I get a shit ton of money.
Turret plating will soon fall.
There you go. 600 gold, baby, into my pocket. Let's go. Sag?
I hear the innocent. You have been slain.
Okay. Is that even worth it anymore? I guess you can herald and one shot the turret, I guess. He'll die. Probably have to give it one auto, huh? Good job, brother! The voice ask you has got it. Nice!
Cleansing blood with silver. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
Dominion for that. Oh, I lost two. Not worth.
Beware.
I love that Caitlyn's like, boom, what up? Yeah, they kind of entered there, huh?
Evil lurks around everything.
What do you got, brother? What do we got, brother? You missed your arrow, brother! Literally, right when that Karthus all came down, this is me.
An enemy has been slain.
good dodges on some of the shurikens. Sorry. That's cheating. You E Diana when she's on midway E, so she could have refreshed her E duration. I think it refreshed. I think she landed on me.
Your team has destroyed a turret.
It's so fast. All this late. That the only way I think you can actually cancel it is if you tell Diana to wait for you to E, and then for Diana to E for it to get canceled. That's the only way you can cancel it. If you get hit by the Q, you have to ask her to wait.
On wings of night.
Check out that video if you want to see how I tumble. I'm part assist. But it doesn't do anything, just keep that in mind.
An enemy has been
slain. Why no crit? Crit's ass, man. It's like booty hole. Booty. She healed. Mother. Silver letter. Yeah, Ginsu's makes it so you can never crit ever again if you buy the item. It instead converts the crit into physical damage so that you get guaranteed damage instead. Man, I sometimes still see people run Domination 2nd on Vayne top of my rank games. They lose lane automatically after that. Domination is good if you're gonna buy QSS. If you're against like a Warwick jungle, Skarner jungle, or you know you for sure have to build QSS because they have like Lissandra or Malzahar, you should always run Taste and Genius Hunter on Vayne top. But any Vayne player who runs Domination Tree with no game plan in mind is just all coping. They're coping that Taste the Blood Ravenous Hunter is still in the game. But I would cope too, to be honest. Ravenous Hunter was so broken on Vayne. It was so good, man, with your fucking W. I kind of miss it too. Is Vayne ADC playable in your opinion, below Diamond? Yeah, below Diamond, sure. Yeah, that's fine. You son of a bitch. I'm so sad I did not kill the fucking clip. so sad. What's up, Oblivion? How you doing today? That Zed's so trash. He had no ult, so he had to flashy. I think he could have killed me though without flash, but he wanted to secure it. Any tips on Vayne ADC? Play the game? I don't know what else to tell you. It's like I can feed you bullshit if you want. My partner is like, all right, farm better. Okay, farm better. Very nice. Okay. Play the waves properly, right? Okay, very nice. Be mindful of where the enemy support is and draw their zone of influence. Like, I can give you all that bullshit. None of it's gonna help you. Like, that's what other streamers would tell you, but like, there's nothing for me to tell you from ADC. It's like, it's so bad. You play the matchup like any other matchup. You mechanically output, you dodge their abilities with zone of influence, and fucking... you crash waves properly and you last it. Like, that's like legit everything. You know what I mean? I smell. And then try not to get fucked. That's like Vayne ADC. Vayne ADC tips. The shadows are to be feared. To this day, I've been streaming for 2 years now. I don't know what to say when somebody asks me, do you have any tips? Shut down. I don't know how to respond to it. Like, what am I supposed to say? You know what I mean? It's like one of the hardest things to answer. I'm so fucking sad. Because here's the thing, I listen to other streamers, right? I listen to other streamers, and they say, farm better. Okay. Who the fuck does not know that? Of course you're supposed to farm better. In the dark, all is laid. They know they're supposed to farm better. Why do you need to tell them? What else? Stop dying. That one's the biggest bullshit I've heard in my life. The better thing to say is... make sure that you play the waves properly so that when you're in a position to try to make a play happen, you can make the play happen. Don't die a worthless death. Make sure the death, like, something came of it. Like, you tried to do something. You tried a good 1v2 that had a good chance of succeeding. Something along those lines. Stop dying, biggest bullshit ever. Like, who are these streamers telling you to stop dying? Like, and I've heard these things from other streamers that I talk to, like, but they even tell me, like, they don't know what to say. So they just feed the bullshit over and over again. Stop being bad. Okay, thank you. Stop dying. Okay, thank you very much. Here are my tips. If you want real tips. Start learning the maximum capabilities of your champions by maximizing the output. Auto attacks in between your movement, abilities in between your movements, and start learning that. If you do that, you will destroy everyone in platinum, gold, silver, iron. If you are just maximizing the DPS of your champion relative to your character moving around, that is the first step. Number two, understand everyone's range, understand how fast abilities go, and how long you need relative to you for you to dodge that shit. That's what you need to do. Step number three, learn wave management. Guys, I'm inting. After you learn weight management... Oh no, weight management should be last. Third should be learn the spacing and tethering game. Learn how to play with your maximum auto attack and your movement speed. So it'll be a mixture of zone of influence. Then learn wave management, number four. And from there, if you perfect all four of those things, you'll naturally learn how to win a game, which is step number five. That's it. That is like the five like important things to League of Legends, no matter what champion you play. Mechanics, understanding what everyone does so you can create a game plan. Number three, spacing and tethering game. Number four, wave management. Number five, I don't have a video on it, but number five is learning how to actually win the game. I do everything in my YouTube videos, but teach you how to win a game. I don't teach people how to win a game. That's why I don't teach. The reason why I don't teach people on how to win a game of League of Legends is because you should be able to figure that out on your own if you are doing the things that are correct leading up to that point. Let me give you guys a video right now. Let me give you guys a playlist. Here. I'm Parnassus. Watch those seven videos. Double kill. Evil lurks around every... And anyone else who wants to get better. Seven videos. Literally, it's free. Explains everything I literally just said. And in every single game, I apply those concepts. Every single one. There's not one game where I don't apply it. Those are... Those four... It's four concepts, but it's seven videos. Four concepts will get you better at the game.